Norway, rich in petroleum, is also a global leader in renewable energy use at 98%, and cleaner, more inexpensive electricity is helping to drive the push of electric vehicles into the mainstream market. Roughly 1 in 6 cars sold in Norway is an EV, a whopping 15% share. Norway has the most EVs per capita of any country, although its love for zero-emission vehicles didn't develop overnight. For nearly 3 decades, nascent support for EVs by owners and local governments has grown into national incentive schemes and a robust charging infrastructure. Head of the Parliamentary Committee for Energy and Environment, Ura Elvestuen, said the incentives had created the nationwide EV market.
Took away all the taxes on electric cars when we introduced the other incentives. They could park for free, they can charge for free, they can use the bus lines, they can reuse the toll rings for free. Then slowly in the beginning, but for the last few years, it has really taken off.
Since sales began in 2011, Nissan Leaf has become the nation's third best-selling car with over 15,000 on Norway's roads. In the city of Apgardia, Mayor Ildri Adam and her municipal board considered practicality and economy, as well as the environment, when deciding on 30 Nissan Leafs for traveling healthcare staff.
It was a better solution when it comes to environment, and we actually saved $100,000 a year in running the cars.
Using the Leaf on her rounds, Elsa Busnes complimented the quiet ride, ease of driving and visibility, but said the environmental benefits were key.
Men grunnen til at så mange har kjøpt elbil er vel også at vi har veldig gode ordninger med støtte både til å kjøpe de og at det blir subsidiert litt. At det er gunstig å kjøpe og kjøre elbil i Norge per i dag, da. Men mange tenker jo så klart også på miljøet.
Christina Bu, Secretary General of the Oslo-based Norwegian Electric Vehicle Association, with 13,500 members, said EVs are so popular that criticism of national incentives is growing.
This is definitely a start of a paradigm shift. And as with every paradigm shift, that's not necessarily happen easily. Some car producers, for example, has not yet put an EV into market, but we just think, well, you better do then.
Norway will maintain incentives until total EV sales reach 50,000 cars or until 2017, but most expect the mark to fall next year. That is when Oslo will have more than 1,000 EVs as part of its municipal fleet.
To have also a zero emission fleet of cars is one part of a bigger strategy that any city should have. And for Oslo, other cities also in Norway, that is the case. I mean, they use way more money and put much more energy into public transportation system, get good bike lanes and other projects. Comparatively, I mean, it has been quite easy to build up a good infrastructure for electric cars. The goal is to make a emission-free transportation system.
In Oslo, Nissan sales manager Eirik Nilsen said owners show their passion for EVs in what is called the neighbor effect.
We got so many customers coming in because their neighbors had got it, and their friends and their colleagues. One of the guys who sold most Leafs in Norway, and he actually got one customer who's provided him with the 6 new sales.
In Europe and across the globe, Norway is clearly setting the pace in creating a zero emission tomorrow by building its EV infrastructure today.